All right, students, today we are going to do measures 5 to 8 of Happy Blues for violin. So we have our paper where we've already put our first line. We're going to start our second line now. So the first thing we're going to do is draw the treble clef. So I'm going to do my line coming down. And if you want to, you can do the curly Q like I did here, but I'm not going to do it right now. Then we're going to take this and we're going to bring it down and come around like this. We are not going to put our meter on, so we have a little bit more space on this line. The next thing we're going to do is put our bar lines on to create our measures. So I'm going to close over here with a bar line, and then I'm going to make a bar line in roughly the middle. And now I have two measures, but I need four. So I'm going to divide this in half, and then I'm going to divide this one in half, and now I have four measures for line two. I'm going to number them. So at the top line, we had measures 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this starts with 5, 6, 7, and 8. Good. Now I'm going to draw my note G. And our first two notes are G here, and we know that they're going to be eighth notes because it's the same rhythm as the first line. So they're going to look like this. But for our G, we have to make two lines going below our music staff like this, and then draw our note head. And then we have to do that again. These are called ledger lines. They extend the music staff down below so that we can get our low note G. And once you have your two G's, please look. The space between the music staff is about the space between these extra ledger lines, okay? And I'm gonna put my stems on. And then I'm gonna connect them together with a beam, and I'm gonna make it a little darker since it's kind of near that line. And then I need to put my rest, rest, rest. So I'm gonna draw my quarter rest, a Z and then a C, a Z and then a C, and a Z, and then a C. And then I'm going to do four G's that are quarter notes. So I have to draw these ledger lines again. Here's one set, two, three, and four. And then I'm going to draw my note heads. You could draw your note heads before you finish all these ledger lines if you'd like to, but you'll notice that the note head is hanging from the bottom ledger line. Good. And once we've done that, we're going to put the stems on. The stems go on the right side of the note head. Now the hard part is done, because let's look. Line two here, this is the same as line one. So all I have to do in these two measures is copy these two measures. So I'm going to do D's. And then another D, and then put my bar lines on and connect them for eighth notes. And then I'm going to put my three quarter rests with a Z and then a C and a Z and then a C. And then I'm going to do my four quarter notes over here. So I'm going to go one, do my note heads first, two, three, and four. And now I'm going to put my stems on. One, two, three, four. This one kind of looks funny, so I'm going to try to fix them. There we go. Now I've got all my line two done. Now I'm going to put in my bows, bow markings. So I'm going to put in my up bows and my down bows. So I'm going to start here. I'm going to do down and up. And after the rests, down, up, down, up, down, up, and then down, up, down, up. And now the only thing left is to put in the counting. So I'm going to write in one and, use a plus sign for and then put in capital R for rests like this, and then do 1, 2, 3, 4. And then here, I'm going to do again, one and, rest, 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 1, 2, three, four. Good. Let's clap and count it, starting on second line. Ready, go. One, and rest, rest, rest. One, two, three, four. One, and rest, rest, rest. One, two, three, four. And that, my friends, is the second line of Happy Blues.